You're listening to Radio Cosmos.
All night long.
Bravo!
My copper was a little late.
Come on, sir. Come on, sir.
Break for 30 seconds.
Come on, sir.
You're now listening to Bad Radio.
Hello and welcome to Bad Radio. Bad stands for Business at a Distance. This is a show about local businesses and business networking. We are here in the News Radio WFLA studio from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. I'm your host, Angela Smurrito. In the studio with me, we have our producer, Melissa Fox.
Hi.
Oh, I like that one. We're going to keep that
one. Yeah, keep that one.
Okay. And then to my left, we have Melissa Jacob with Striking Brand.
Hi, hello.
Hey, hi, hi.
Wow, I feel like...
You really should. Like a champ. All right, guys. Knock it off.
I'm in a theater or something.
Sit down.
Melissa is our co-host and our videographer. And if you go to badradio.com, that's BAADradio.com, under the episodes page, you can see all of the previous episodes and all of the previous guests there. She does a beautiful job. And then if you want to see her other work, you can go to strikingbrand.com, because not only is she a videographer, but she is also a very talented photographer.
Thank you.
She's amazing. Mm-hmm.
And so today we have Rock and Brews and Oviedo from Oviedo in the house. So please please join me in welcoming Tavo Mendez. Got that right.
Happy beauty, sweet
Everybody
plum.
Knows Tavo.
And then Kendall Kearse.
Happy beauty, sweet plum.
Kendall was a little nervous, so we got to make her feel nice and cozy.
Okay, hold on. I got something for you.
There. Oh, no.
Yes. It'll be fine. It'll be just
fine.
It'll
be a warm welcome.
A warm welcome. And
all right!
There it is.
Wait. So, and we also have food in the studio.
That's our
third guest that's in here today.
Yeah, we saw the food.
It smells amazing. Mm-hmm. I told Tavo, I'm like, oh, I don't eat right before because I'm scared it's going to mess like my throat up and then I'm going to be like the whole time, which is the worst. All right, so we're going to talk about the networking news, which is the first segment that we do here, and it is brought to us by Symphonic CBD, which is a branch of Live Your Best Life, and they are both advocates for Green Compass Global. Green Compass products are USDA, organic, lab-tested, non-GMO, made in the USA, and cruelty-free CBD products, and they are key to making calmness a habit. They also have CBD for our fur babies, our little fur babies, you know, my Roxy, she
Cats
needs
dogs.
Them. And you get more information on the benefits of CBD by visiting symphonic-cbd.com, and that is symphonic-cbd.com. So do you know Terry Mandigo? She's with Live Your Best Life. She does the CBD as well.
Yes, I do. Yes.
Because I saw her mention on
commented
the...
Commented on your post.
Yes.
Hi, Terry.
Hi, Terry.
Now, Terry's actually one of our sponsors.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so thank you to that. Okay, so you guys, we have a fun networking news today. So we're going to do a little trivia.
Ooh, trivia.
Ready? And so, okay, first question.
I suck at trivia.
No,
me
this is,
too.
You guys, this
I
is
rock.
Business trivia. So,
oh, that's perfect for you.
All right. And you, I want your input too, okay?
Oh, thank you.
All right. So, which online marketplace was founded in 1995 and initially started as an online bookstore?
Amazon.
Don't,
damn it.
Amazon.
Okay.
Sorry.
You guys, I had ABC.
Sorry.
Indeed.
That was too easy, though.
All right. I didn't know that.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. So, it was too easy for us.
Sorry. Okay.
We'd be buying books.
All right. Let's try this one then. What popular social media platform was launched in 2004? Okay. I'm going to give you four, okay?
Choices?
A, Twitter. B, LinkedIn. C, Facebook. And D, Instagram. What launched in 2004? I'm going to say, Tavo, you're first. You can pass if you want.
LinkedIn?
Was it Facebook?
Instagram.
No, Facebook wasn't one of the choices, was it?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, okay.
I'll do Facebook.
All right. Ding, ding, ding,
Yay.
Ding, ding.
I knew that.
See, I thought Facebook started before 2004.
So no, that's MySpace.
Mm-hmm. Was it?
Yeah, MySpace was first.
Because I remember using Facebook for high school reunions, like getting everybody together.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
But I could have swore that happened before 2004 because I graduated. Well, anyway. I'm old. I'm old. All right. Which tech company slogan is Think Different? Is it A, Google, B, Microsoft, C, Apple, or D, Samsung? All right. Raise your hands or, like, you know, if you know the answer, go ahead.
C.
It Apple. Is Apple. How do you know all this stuff?
I'm an Apple person.
I don't even know this stuff. Do you guys know that? Did you know that?
I didn't know which one.
It's the Melissa's. It's our day.
Yeah, we win.
Our trivia day.
Okay. this would be one that you should know. Okay. What fast food chain is known for Golden Arches logo and famous for? Oh, just
really?
Come on,
Kreskies.
I'm going to say McDowell's. You know what McDowell's is from?
Why, yes, I do. I live in Queens.
Do you know what we're talking about?
Movie?
Coming to
America?
Was it Coming to America? Yeah. So it's not the Golden Arches. It's the Golden Arcs. So that was on the other day on Netflix. So I had to watch it. The kids are always like, what is this old movie? And Tom, my husband, is always like, it's classic.
Classic.
Classic. If kids know if it's classic, that means that they're probably not going to like it. Unless it's like really raunchy, like Step Brothers.
Okay.
Then
is that a classic? I don't think that counts.
According to my
Let me just say that we have a very similar new French fry to the Golden Arches, now Rock and Brew. So let me check it out.
Does it have spice on it?
We can make it.
Okay. Because that's what I like.
Cajun seasoning.
I like French fries that have a little spice to them. Because I won't let myself eat French fries very often. So when I do.
It needs to be a meal.
It's got to be like.
Make that happen for you.
All right. So this one's too easy too. All right. I'm going to have to tell them to do it a little bit more hard. But this one is actually quite interesting because do you guys know what year Elon Musk founded Tesla? So I mean, I'll give you A, 99, B, 2000. C, 2001, and D, 2003.
That's so close together.
I know. Got to make it hard.
Not helpful.
C.
What are they? 99, 2000, 2001, 2003?
Because I didn't know this either, and it actually surprised
me. Honestly, I thought it's the first number, the lower number.
99, yeah, that's what I was thinking, too.
It's actually 2003.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, so Tesla started in 2003, so if you think about that, that was 20 years ago.
Oh, gosh. Oh, I know. Stop doing that.
I know. But it's aging us.
Same.
I'm in the 80s were yesterday, and now all of a sudden it's 2023. Did I miss it?
Well, you guys.
So Tesla is older than Facebook? What the heck?
Yeah. That's crazy, right? Mm-hmm. What year were you born?
2000.
Oh, gosh.
That's okay. My daughter was 2004. So that's how I always gauge how old things are because I'm like, okay, my daughter was born in 2004 and then my son 2007. So if I can get it within there, then I can like figure out how old something is pretty quick. Oh, happy birthday to your girl.
Oh, thank you. Sweet 16. That's a big one.
So give her a shout out.
I will. Oh, happy birthday, Marin. We love you so much, obviously.
Happy birthday, Marin.
She's the best.
So what is her sign?
What's her sign?
October birthday.
Libra.
Okay. Because I don't really know any October birthdays. I think I have a niece or nephew that has an October birthday. I think so. But,
my birthday's the 12th. My birthday's the 12th.
Is it really? So you guys are both?
It's like back to back. And then my brother is the 16th. My cousin, my niece is like the 14th. It's like we have a big October birthdays celebration.
You should.
Like half the family.
Is it a Halloween theme?
Sometimes it is.
This is when you just like wrap them all up in 1 month and be done with it.
A big shindig.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you know, I ran out of trivia questions. So what else do you guys want to talk about? No, I'm just kidding.
Let's talk about these fries again.
I know.
What's that about?
Let's talk about the fries.
Let's talk about the food.
Yeah.
All right. Tell us what you brought here today.
Yeah.
Miss Kendall.
So we have our margarita flatbread pizza. We have half of it with chicken, which you can add, but it typically doesn't come with it on there. A little dessert platter for you guys, bread pudding, raindrops, brownies. Mm.
Tell them what the raindrops are.
So our raindrops are like a puff pastry, like our version of a beignet or like kind of a pastry donut. Pastry, chocolate inside, powdered sugar, and then a bit of a raspberry drizzle on top.
Super I saw good. The brownies over there. Those have my name.
And it's served with homemade whipped cream.
Nice. Yeah, our whipped cream is crazy good.
I'd get crazy good. Like I said, that's one of my favorite things to think about is food. If it's good, is one thing. If it's crazy good, that's the best. But I'm like a sucker for a good brownie.
Are you a foodie?
No, I'm not. Maybe. I'm a sugary. I like my sugar.
Same.
But the flatbreads are something that I think is really good too because it's like one of those things that you can have as an appetizer, or you could also have it as a meal.
Yeah, and ours are gluten free.
Actually, you know what that music means? That means that we're getting ready to go to break. But since we're already talking about the food, when we get back, we're going to talk more about the food. So you guys stay tuned. When we get back, we're going to have more with Rock and Bruce. So stay tuned.
Sounds good. I'm going to go over there and get my face full of food because I can't hold out any longer. This is Bad Radio on News Radio, WFLA, Orlando.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore, because a couple that plays together stays together.
Welcome back, and this portion of the show is brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore. Hey guys, it's time to head over to Premier Couple Superstore and surprise your sweetheart with that sexy bedroom outfit. Premier Couple Superstore has got a huge selection of lingerie, shoes, toys, games, love oils, and a ton of great gifts. With Premier Couple Superstore, you don't pay those high prices because you go directly to the source. 5009 South OBT or shop online at premiercouples.net, because a couple that plays together stays together.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. That was an aggressive one.
You
I'm sorry,
missed your
missed
cue.
It.
That actually that scared me.
Plays what together going?
So we have Rock and Brews Oviedo in the house today, and we're very excited to welcome Tavo Mendez and Kendall Kiss.
Yes.
Woo-hoo!
And all the lovely food they brought. So we were talking a little bit about the food, but what I want to do is I want to just rewind and start from the beginning, because Tavo emailed me. He goes, what are you going to talk about? Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, the first thing I want to talk about is the history of Rock and Brews, because my husband Tom started to tell me a little bit about it, and I was like, you're kidding. The guys from Kiss started
it? Oh, yeah.
So I want to hear, let's hear the story.
Of course. Yes. So a company started in El Segundo, a little industrial town in California, about 10 minutes south of the LAX airport, back in 2010 by Michael Sisley's and the Ferrano brothers. backtracking back in the 60s, the Ferrano brothers were actually band promoters, and they kind of started, they did start right. the merchandise concert.
T-shirts? Like
t-shirts, right.
They're huge. Concert and t-shirts are huge. Even for my kids, they're huge.
I mean, everybody wears them. Mm-hmm. And thus, when you go to our restaurants, you'll see all these awesome album covers and all this artwork, because we, you know, company owns it.
Right.
And so through that deal back, they made so many connections. And fast forward to 2010, they were just hanging out backstage with Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley, you know, just like a normal
That's
concert,
so cool.
just like anybody. And
like
throughout
do.
The years, he always mentioned that he wanted to be a part of something bigger. He did partner up with the Hot Rod Cafe owners, and he's like, all right, this is a cool theme, and someday, hopefully,
is Hard
I'll
Rock
be able
even
to...
still a thing? Or
yes.
are they all shut?
I don't know.
Girl, there's one at Universal.
Not you anymore.
Yes, there
no,
is.
No, there still is.
I have not been, so I don't know.
You're Universal Queen, aren't
still
you?
Still there.
With Harry Potter?
Universal.
It's still there.
Oh, yeah.
Was
Sorry.
So much cooler than
Wait,
that
no.
Though.
I'm thinking of Planet Hollywood.
Yeah, who cares about that anyways? Right? We're talking about Rock
Sorry,
and Bruce.
No. I thought I was thinking of Planet Hollywood, so... Yeah.
Okay.
yeah. All right. I get that.
So the Ferrano brothers, Dave, you know, said I want to own one of these, something like it. And again, 2010, and they were just hanging out and said nothing's better than, you
food.
Know, rock and brews.
Food.
And there it was. Then we were, you know, came to inception.
So 2010.
Yeah. Most of the corporate restaurants are up in Cali, south and north. They kind of like now started getting some casinos and arenas. So
oh, really?
they're all over the place. St. Louis, Oklahoma, just opened up one in Bruce City, you know, Wisconsin. We're international. We have one in Mexico, Cabos.
Nice.
There's someone in some in Hawaii. Again, these are all corporate.
Right.
But they actually wanted to come to this side of the coast, and our company president, CEO, Scott Paul, has been a restaurateur, worked for Marriott, an Outbacker for 15 years. Mm-hmm. I myself was an Outbacker for about 10 years, so there's a lot of food and
right.
restaurant industry
Was that
knowledge.
Darden? Was that Darden?
That was Blooming uh-huh. Brands.
Okay.
Oh, I thought it was Darden.
No.
Yeah.
But they called on us and said, hey, we're trying to bring this to the East Coast, and you want to partake? And we said, of course.
I'm curious how you picked Oviedo, though.
Well, we get that all the time, that question. why out of, and yeah, it was the first, you know, franchise store on this side of the States. And
say that
our
louder.
Principal owners.
Yeah, say that louder. So Rockin' Brews Oviedo is the first Rockin' Brews
first.
On the East Coast.
On the East Coast.
Yes. Yep.
That's pretty cool.
And
so that's what I'm talking about.
Our owners, the guys that make all the decisions, they live in Dallas, Texas, and Arizona. They became millionaires and not billionaires through commercial real estate. So they just do all kinds of deals all over the states, and they happen to own that entire plaza where we stay, what we built.
Right.
Right from that new medical building up until the other side of Macaroni Grill. Mm-hmm. So we own that. So he said, well, I'm going to take, we're going to go in and buy into this franchise. It's a great product, great brand. We believe in it. But let me just put it on my land just in case.
Gotcha.
And that's what we're able to build. And, I mean, it did. Within a couple of years, we're able to get a return on investment, and it's very profitable. We now have 7 stores. We're about to build another Texas restaurant towards the end of the year, hopefully, if not the first quarter or next. And we're planning to have our second Tampa location and next year as well.
Very nice.
We're doing very well. We own Texas, Florida, Arizona, and New Mexico. Mm-hmm.
Isn't there another one in Orlando?
Yes, there is. I was
telling Angela
earlier. Sorry, little radio nervousness. That we get that all the time.
I'll put it in there for you.
We get that all the time. It's like, oh, there's one in Oviedo. Like, I've always known the Orlando. It is definitely the cash cow, the busiest store in our franchise and in our region. I mean,
where is that at?
Really?
It's 436.
Right before the airport, Hazeltine and Lee Vista. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's about a dozen hotels, all that business travel. Mm-hmm. It's crazy busy.
I would say a lot of tourist business. Mm-hmm.
Which is great. Great visibility, and they put our name out there. But, you know, we're pretty busy ourselves. We stay creative and productive while very
Well, you're very involved. Yeah, very. Yeah. And I mean, the good thing is like, first and foremost, you have good parking. And I think that no matter what for restaurants, if you've got good parking, then you've already got like a step above over half of the restaurants, because parking is such a thing, especially for people from Florida, because we don't know how to parallel park. And so street parking for us is next
a pain.
A pain. Can you parallel park?
Yes, but it is a pain. I agree.
You're from up north, though. You know, you're
I moved
Army.
Around.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I was born and raised here, and I cannot parallel park. So for me, it's like when I'm going to go someplace, the first thing I do is check out the parking lot. I know.
That's hilarious.
Because I don't want to embarrass myself.
And then their outdoor space is amazing.
Yes.
And then that you let dogs, and you have like, don't you have like little treats for dogs that you can give them?
We
to
do.
You? That's my favorite thing. Anytime a restaurant has like stuff for little pets,
they have their own little menu. They have their own little beds.
They have their own beer.
You have a dog menu?
You have a dog
beer.
I didn't know that.
Did you hear her? They have a dog beer.
No,
they have dogs.
Yes.
Summertime, we make a little doggy desserts as well.
Like that's really sweet. But even Redbug is getting more and more busy. Mm-hmm. And then with like we had like you mentioned Kathy Droke with the hospital with Oviedo Hospital.
Hi Kathy.
Mm-hmm. Hi Kathy. But I mean, all those places, Oviedo's growing. Winter Springs is growing, and I mean, like you said, the mall's kind of on its, I don't even know what to think of the mall.
They're trying.
Go there because it has a candle store. I'm like, I'm going to the candle store.
Yeah.
But other than
I need candles, actually. When you just said that, I was like, oh, I guess I'm going to the mall today.
Redbug. Yeah. Redbug is a good road to be off of, especially, like I said, with all the growth in that area. But what we were talking about, too, is that your involvement in the community. So I think that is something that, like, since this is a show about local businesses and business networking, that's something I definitely want to talk about. So, first of all, when did you get started with Rockin' Brews?
Since day one. There's a picture of me standing in the middle of like just nothing before even it got built. So I moved out here.
You got to see it from the first stone, huh?
Yep,
that's cool.
Yep, literally. And about almost 2 years ago, I moved my entire family out here from Tampa. That's where our headquarters space, our CEO, president lives there, our home office, accounting,
for all of
everything for our franchise,
okay,
for
gotcha.
The Florida LLC.
And Kendall, what about you? You started how many years ago?
A little over 4 years ago.
Right. Oh, there's music. That means we're going to break. But when we get back, we're going to talk more about how both of these guys got started and where they're going to go from here. So stay tuned for more Bad Radio.
I still want to talk about the food that's not in the studio. I promise.
I'm lying. This is Bad Radio. Check out BAADradio.com. We're on News Radio WFLA Orlando.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore. Because a couple that plays together stays together.
Welcome back, and this portion of Bad Radio is brought to you by Forge IT Consulting, providing a fully outsourced IT department with a personal touch for small business. No company is too small. ForgeITConsulting.com. I kind of mixing things up a little bit with the sponsorships, but it's
you do it, girl.
Yeah. So we're talking with Rockin' Brews, and before we went to break, this is how I do it. I build pictures in my head. So how somebody got started and what role they play. So you said about 4 years ago, right?
Yes, I started at the airport location that we were just talking about as a host. And then I just gradually made my way up serving, bartending, doing the training for the stores, and then up to management. And then I got to go over to Oviedo and work with Tavo. So it's been really awesome.
She's an amazing manager.
Aw, look at it. We're so happy. Aw. But honestly, that says a lot about an organization. If somebody's going to start like up front, being a greeter and then going into management, that means that not only is your work environment good, it means that you have growth opportunity. And for businesses to grow, like I said, I think that all that has so much to say about the culture and then like just the managers that you have around you.
We have some amazing managers, not just like Kendall, some guys that came in as busboys and dishwashers. Oviedo has produced three GMs, the lady,
that's awesome.
The girl that goes and appears at Kissimmee, Katrina Hinkle, was also a UCF student that came in to us many years ago, and then we built her up, and now she is kicking butt down at the Kissimmee location as a GM. So that's our kind of like, we want to make sure that we build people up. We don't hire bartenders even from the outside. We would like to promote from within. I'm happy to say that over 9 years in business, there's about a dozen of my original employees that's still with us at Oviedo. My original salad guy, my original fry guy, my original prep lady, especially in the back of the house.
Yeah.
You know? And as you mentioned earlier, the business, I mean, someone would offer 50 cents more and you're like, okay, I'm out. You know, I'm going next door. Or as a waitress, you tend to make a little bit more money on any given shift. And but with us, I mean, you come to us, and my two ladies in the morning, Amber and April, have been serving there since inception, since day one. So, and many of these people have been with us. Our marketing manager was our little host for us.
Oh, that's great. These are careers, and that's what makes me so happy to think about that.
My finance, one of our finance, which ended up getting finance degree from UCF, she started as a hostess also, Brittany Kaysen, 9 years ago,
very nice.
that's her career. So we're very lucky to have these people. And yeah, the culture, we all about their time. We have picnics once a year.
Nice.
We have retreats. We have employees of the month. We dress up, we just make it fun.
This is so heartwarming because, like, having that many people that stay on, 100% what that is management, taking care of their people and, like, having a good environment around 100%.
I agree.
Or else they would have left for any other reason. So, that, and just, like, having the picnics and stuff like that, I'm like,
this is fun.
Oh, I love it.
And believe me, people do end up leaving for various reasons. And oftentimes, there's always knocking on the door like, hey, so the grass wasn't that greener.
Right.
Will you take me back? And
take
I'm always like, of course. And so it's a great environment. I'm so lucky to have a great team. You know, we love what we do. We genuinely love what we do and show up and whatever it takes. We were voted best restaurant by the Oviedo Winter Springs Chamber.
How many times? Like several, I think, right?
I was telling her, like, we've been second place, third place. Yeah.
Right.
This year we took number one.
That's wonderful.
We also took best community involvement.
Absolutely wonderful.
As a restaurant, that is such a huge honor. We, you know, even beat some of the nonprofits in Oviedo and Winter Springs. But, I mean, you see what we do. We sponsor about a dozen schools around the area.
Well, that's one thing that I wanted to talk to you about, too. It's like all your community
and
involvement.
And we're like, yeah, just whatever it takes. We just want to make sure that we get back. And Kendall is great about helping us doing that.
Right? I remember my daughter was there once, and she was doing face painting, but I can't remember what it was for. Mm-hmm. Like, you guys had her set out back, and she was doing face painting. And like I said, it was somebody had rented space, or it was somebody that had an event going on there.
We have a very cool painting event, actually. Yeah. Kendall's spearheading that. Why don't you let them know?
So on Wednesday the 11th, we are having Yes You Canvas. They're based in Oviedo as well, Karen Phillips. She's coming out. Here, I'll show you the graphic.
It's all. I'll find it.
So we're doing a Sugar Skull painting. She's going to come out at 6 on the 11th of October, and she's going to sit out with us in that same backyard patio area.
Uh-huh.
Pretty nice, right?
Yeah.
And we're going to do these Sugar Skulls, and it's like $40 per person, and
we'll
it's wine down
food,
Wednesday.
We'll have and you get a glass of wine. So
very nice.
Cool, you know, couples or girls night out. You know,
well,
so
there's three things I still want to talk about. One is the food, one is these events, and then another one is that in community involvement. So mm-hmm. since we're talking about this, how often do you do events like this?
Oh, my gosh.
So we have, like, our bike night event weekly on Thursdays. We have 911 Biker Law come out. They bring a bunch
Michael
of bikers,
Bain.
Vendors. And then they bring out a lot of people. It's really awesome. And then we have trivia nights every Monday with the 5-Minute Professor. And then we have bands weekly, which I brought our calendar for this month.
You mentioned our parking lot where we host free car shows every second Saturday of the month.
Nice.
We open a little earlier for brunch. People don't know this, but we do serve brunch Saturday and Sunday from up until 2. Our secret bottomless mimosas.
Nom, nom, nom.
Doesn't say it on the menu, but ask for them.
Do you have to like have a secret password?
Yeah. And plenty of events, live music.
Can people find all those events on your website?
All of this is right off the website. This is all of our upcoming events, promotions for this month, our live music lineup, which is going to be really awesome. Mm-hmm. A lot of local bands, so it's super exciting.
Oh, where do they play?
They play in our patio.
Oh, cool.
Well, there's two different. There's like the front patio, and then there's one that kind of went over to the
wraps
side.
Wraps around, correct?
Yeah.
That 80 seats, plenty of. We've rent that patio for various events. There's 3 weddings. Yes, people have actually married at a restaurant.
Really?
Yes.
Married.
Yeah.
The wedding was
like
there, not the reception.
They walked down the aisle / sidewalk. So it's pretty cool.
That's great.
And, rehearsal dinners, you name it.
Rehearsal dinners, I absolutely can see.
We do. We're very affordable. Don't really charge for the area. We have packages that start at $20 up until $50. So there's companies that come out all the time.
So that's right. You can get online, and this is how we're going to transition into food. So like I said, this is called a transition. But I've been on the website before, and you can buy like groups of things for events and things like that. So is that how the parties, if I say, hey, I have a party of 20 people that I want to bring there, how does that whole thing work?
Usually with larger parties than 20 is usually kind of like our cap. That's when
You don't do bigger parties than 20.
Well, oh, no, we've sold the place for high school reunions. We have 200, 250. Mm-hmm. So, but yeah, tell us a little bit more about how the packages go.
So
and
with
the bookings.
Packages,
we're talking about food packages.
Yeah. So if you want to do a large group, it's a lot easier than everyone ordering individually, just because you can have one person prepay or have people send them the money. So we can go from $20 a person to $55. So those get one drink ticket, so any cocktail or mixed drink or house beer. And then you'll have your choice of however many appetizers based on your tier, however many entrees, or like a dessert platter. Mm-hmm. So if you have a huge group of maybe 100 people, you might do the $40 package where you're getting 3 appetizers and 1 or 2 entrees and a platter. And then your whole party can have all that.
But you get to pick and choose different pieces, right?
Yes.
We have different options, and they just get to choose from the preset menus, but they get to make their own menu.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. And then we also do, like, taco bars and stuff off our catering menu, which people really like because you can build your own tacos. We have the tortillas, the protein, and then all the toppings.
And we'll
separate.
Tailor it however you want it. It could be a plated dinner. It could be a buffet, which is usually what people go because we just keep replenishing the
food.
If your guests arrive early or if someone comes in an hour later, there's always going to be food. And we do a great job about getting those tabs and keeping track of everyone. We host a Real Estate Connection networking event. Last month, we had 97 people.
At a real estate? Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's every third Wednesday of the month. So
very nice.
Yep.
Well,
Well, great for networking.
We have one more segment, and I really do want to talk about the food. We're going to talk about the food, so stay tuned.
That's for last.
Stay tuned for more Bad Radio.
I'm still excited about the food. Rock and Brew in the house right now on Bad Radio.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore, because a couple that plays together stays together.
Welcome back, and this portion of Bad Radio is brought to you by Ground Up Property Services. With the changing of seasons, now is a good time to get your irrigation system serviced, so call Ground Up Property Services today. Also, with hurricane season, is it still hurricane season? Anyway, it's
till the end of November.
Till the end of November.
Say, we're like right in the middle.
Well, there's been a ton of rain, so it's a good idea to ask Rick Hall with Ground Up Property Services about a water sensor, because you don't want your lawn to get too much water. And don't forget about the lawn painting service. If you're planning an outdoor event and you want to hide those brown spots on your lawn, call 407-468-4295. You can also get more information on groundupinc.net. Ground Up is one of our sponsors, and they actually have a lawn painting service for people who like do out, you know, photography or whatever. And if you've got like nasty lawn or something like that, you can come out and spray it and make it look good. Mm-hmm. And it's all eco-friendly. So for the last segment with Rock and Brews, I want to talk about food, because honestly, I've never had a bad meal at Rock and Brews. In fact, we've never had a bad experience from the takeout to dining in to, you know, bringing food to clients. It's always just been, first of all, it's easy, because when I say easy, you guys actually communicate. Like, you, when somebody picks up the phone, they know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
Which I know that sounds
such a low bar.
I know that sounds so simple, but you guys can agree with me that
it's a big deal.
100%.
Like, the customer service is not where it used to be. But like I said, with Rock and Brews, we've always had a really good experience. But again,
well, thank you.
But the food, always top notch. So what is the concept behind the food?
Well, great question. We get oftentimes kind of like, try to avoid your place. We don't really do like bar food. We actually have a culinary team. They're called the Bigfoots. And they're the protectors of the food. We call ourselves a from-scratch kitchen restaurant, since we make items on the house. Our marinara for pizzas are, you know, homemade. We still shred our own cheese. We make our own dressings. As I said, the whipped cream for the desserts is homemade. Black bean sauces.
I'm a huge fan of the pulled pork.
We make everything that comes in through our back doors is always fresh. We don't buy anything frozen. The pulled pork, it's a dry rub recipe that we make in-house. It gets marinated. It stays there for a whole 24 hours. And then we smoke it overnight for 12 to 14 hours. Same deal with our ribs. So that's why when you
ribs. Yes.
Sometimes when you get you go in late night and we might be 86 or we might be out of an item. Because it's fresh.
It's radio. It's fresh. Restaurant
and,
terms.
Right. And but yeah, we pride ourselves in bringing in great items. We have a redfish that gets cooked on a traditional cast iron, you know, with the blackening seasonings. And we make our bourbon sauce, which is made up of shrimp and crawfish and all these like New Orleans flavor, bold flavors. Our rice is homemade. I mean, just there's so much flavors in our food. The burgers, the salads are artisan. I mean, you name it. I still have people out there filleting fish, filleting chicken. Very old school way of producing the food, which is when you eat it, it translates. And people are like, oh, wow. Like I, even if it's a chicken sandwich, even if it's a wing, it wasn't a frozen wing. It was, you know, the ranch was made earlier. We cut the veggies to serve it earlier. So, that's what we pride ourselves on doing the food, and a little bit of for everyone. You know, pastas, tacos, barbecue, as I said. We're known for burgers and wings, but we're much more than
anybody who says like they try to stay away from bar food. Please just check out your menu. Your menu is amazing. And you're right when you say like even the basic stuff, like I think you have something like a Key West BLT or something like that.
Yep.
I love it. It is so good. It's not like a regular like BLT.
Mm-hmm.
so good.
No, it's like he said, it's more gourmet. That's really the way it is. I don't
like ciabatta bread with crispy bacon, a garlic aioli that gets spread throughout, some fresh romaine and Roma tomatoes, and a homemade Italian dressing over the smoked turkey.
Does that sound like a regular BLT?
No, it doesn't.
Amazing. That's so good.
Yep, and we have a Cuban sandwich with our homemade pulled pork with homemade mojo sauce, very traditional. I mean, I could just go on and on and on. You know, the fillets, there's people that actually come in and they're like, you know, for this type of atmosphere, I wouldn't expect to have an amazing fillet. So we come in for the fillets. So I'm like, all right, sweet, thanks. but yeah, it's amazing. The food, it's what we always tell people. We do have a great atmosphere with the music and the ambiance, but it's the food and the service what I feel keeps bringing everybody back. And no, someone's dissatisfied, please just tell us. Don't go on to the interwebs like someone left a review the other day. It's like, oh, I had a bad experience, but I just went to the interwebs. I'm like, dude, don't. Come tell us. We would have fixed it. We would have.
There are some people. It doesn't matter what you do. There's miserable people out there that are just gonna leave bad stuff. And you know, it's like you just have to like.
Not just the food, the drinks.
Yeah.
Tell them about the drinks. Tell them about $6 mules on Mondays.
Oh yeah.
$6 mules.
Okay. Mules.
Mules. Sorry.
But we have a whole new drink coming out in our next new menu in about 2 months. So we're going super heavy into like. More craft drinks. So we're getting smoke guns. We're getting different flavor blasters. It's all this crazy, awesome stuff. We're doing a whole revamp. So new cocktails, a whiskey flight with our Metallica Black and whiskey, new beers. We're running away a little bit from the bottled beers just so we can focus in on these new cool cocktails. We're going to have like a smoked old fashioned.
You're more than welcome to come out and test.
Are people receptive to like trying the new drinks?
Yeah, he tried one the other day. And I haven't been there to really get a taste,
They're
we're going to have our meeting on Tuesday to start making them, and I can't wait.
As soon as
she's like, woohoo, it's meeting time.
Yeah. As soon as she started talking about these craft drinks, I lit up because I take pictures for a restaurant of these.
They're going to be awesome.
Let me take pictures for you.
Okay.
I'll send you some.
If you don't want to go into this intricate, elaborate drinks, I mean, we still have our $2 off from Wind Down Wednesdays. We have a $7 mojitos. We have a $6 meals on Mondays, $5 mimosas and Bloody Marys on the weekend. So there's still a great happy hour that you guys can come out and, you know, half off appetizers as well from 3 to 6 Monday to Friday. So great, great specials. I know people are kind of like, you know, tying their belt right now with what's going on everywhere. But we make it affordable and we make it fun. So please, please do come see us. Check us out. Say hi to Miss Kendall and I.
What do you have for the kiddos?
Oh, yeah. We got a bunch of stuff for them. We're thinking about, with Yes You Canvas, going into doing maybe a kids' paint night, a lot more fun for the families. Me and her have to set up dates. So we're going to see how.
I think that's a brilliant
does.
Idea. Yeah. I know. Yeah, I know a lot of people that would go to that with the kids.
Awesome. But for families, for kids 12 and under, they have a their own kid menu. Very affordable, $6. That includes a drink. Big portions, mac and cheese with a side of
that's
fries.
That's what my son
decides
to get, the mac
or
and cheese. Or a
kid burger with
the
big
it.
Fruit. Yeah, and their drinks. So we want to, again, make it affordable for families to come out and indulge and have a good, you know, let not the wife cook that day, come out and have fun. And they can be themselves and be loud and, you know, it's not the place where they're going to, you know, to behave. We're a fun restaurant. So
well, it sounds like you guys do a really good job on like getting something for everybody. Because you talked about the music. Tell us real quickly. I know we are coming up to the end here, but just tell us how the music works so when people can know when they can come out.
So every other Friday and Saturday. So we'll do Friday, Saturday, and then 2 weeks later we'll do another round. We have local bands come out, play from 7 to about 10 to 11. And this month, starting in October, we're going to have Sonic City on the 6th, Blazing Sands on the 7th, Gin and Tonics on the 20th, and then the 21st, we're going to have one of our like premier bands, Ancient Sun. They always bring a ton of people out.
Very nice. But I mean, even without the live band, there's always music going on.
Always.
There is. And to answer your question, I want to make sure that people know for lunch, for instance, we have a different playlist, a little bit more of soft rock. People are able to still carry on a conversation, bring in mom for lunch, have a little business luncheon. We can accommodate that. And then, of course, later on, it gets a little bit more lively and fun.
we're coming to the end of the show. Tell everybody how to get in touch with you guys. Best way to order is going to be online, right?
Yes, yep. You can also do reservations online. You can go on our website, call us, 7131 Red Buck Lake Road in Oviedo, right bordering Winter Springs.
Thank you guys so much for being here today.
Thank you. We had a lot of fun.
All right, and you can find me at strikingbrand.com.
All right, well, stay tuned for another hour of Bad Radio.
Check out badradio.com if you'd like to be a part of the network and that goes on right here.
You're listening to Radio Cosmos.
All night long.
Bravo!
My papa was a little late.
Come on, Josh. Come on, Josh.
Break for 3 seconds.
Come on,
Josh.
You're now listening to Bad Radio.
Welcome back as we launch into the second hour of Bad Radio. I'm going to run through all the regular info for those of you who just might have joined us. I am Angela Cimarito, your host. And we've got our producer, Melissa Fox.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Is my 44 seconds up?
Yes.
Okay.
And our beautiful co-host is Melissa Jacob with Striking Brand.
Hi. Hello.
And if you it's not fair that she gets the buttons in there.
So
if you go to badradio.com, and that's BAADradio.com, you can see all the previous episodes of Bad Radio. They live there as well as on YouTube. And she just does a beautiful job with the production on those. And if you go to strikingbrand.com, which is her business, you can see all of her other work because she is a videographer as well as a photographer. Mm-hmm. And okay, so we have a new guest. I'm very excited to introduce Stefan Brand with Body Street in Winter Park.
Thank you for the button.
So I got to meet Stefan, I think it's been about 2 weeks now, and I just fell, first of all, I fell in love with the location. So kudos on having a really great place in Winter Park. It's right off of
Orange Avenue.
Mm-hmm. So let's just start by telling everybody what Body Street is. It's not a gym. It's not a. How do you even describe it in a couple of?
It's hard because it's if I say gym or fitness studio, people have pictures in mind and people have smells.
Here, pull that up closer to you.
Smells in mind.
Yeah,
smells.
And I mean, you know how gyms smell. And that's why we always say, forget everything that you think about gym. We are a fitness studio, but a totally new kind fitness studio here in the United States. We do we are a boutique location. We have maximum 2 people at the same time. Mm-hmm. And we do workouts with electrical muscle stimulation. And I explain that later.
Uh-huh.
And thank you for the compliments for the location and for the studio. So I give that back to the franchise in Germany. They did all the thinking behind
that. Oh, they found the location?
No, we found the location, but they helped us with the design and all of that. Mm-hmm. So yeah, Body Street has 300 locations globally. I think 350 locations now globally, mainly in Germany, where I come from, mm-hmm. where my accent comes from. And and
you're
opened
from Munich, right?
From Munich, Germany, yes. And we opened the first Body Street studio here in the United States 3 years ago.
So when you lived in Germany, did you frequent Body Street?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I did. I was a member at Body Street for 5 years.
And then tell us how this whole happened. Okay, you lived in Germany. Mm-hmm. You were a client of Body Street. Now you live in the United States and you own a Body Street. There's a whole lot of stuff mm-hmm. to fill in there.
Yes, I hope we have 2 hours here because it's a long... No, I tried to make it quick and short. So
this is your... Well, we have time.
There's different streams. So yeah, I had 2 corporate careers before I did this. I worked 20 years for McDonald's and then 8 years for Apple. And the last position that I had at Apple, I was looking after the Apple retail stores in North Germany. Probably you know Munich is in South Germany, mm-hmm. so there was a lot of traveling involved.
Mm-hmm.
And so I didn't have time to go to the gym anymore. Mm-hmm. And I went to the gym 3-4 times a week. I kind of liked it. It was my good... I wasn't a gym rat, but I kept myself in shape. And with this new job, I didn't have time to go to the gym anymore. And I got a problem because I gained weight pretty fast. I was 35. And that's the time if you stop working out, you gain weight pretty fast.
52.
Yes. Yeah, right here. It's not getting better the older you get. So and then I saw Body Street and they promised we get you in shape with a 20-minute workout once a week. And I was like, okay, this works for me. And I did a test trial.
But you never once said, how is that even possible? You just said, okay.
No, Body Street Studios are all over the place. So I was like...
Familiar with it?
I think it works. So if you if you see in Munich alone, they have 50 locations.
That's
50. So you think it's something that works, right? Otherwise, they wouldn't have so many locations. So I signed up. I did the test trial. I loved it. I felt like you felt like this really, really good sore, like feeling that you had a really, really good, good workout after 20 minutes. And they kept me in shape with just one workout a week. And so I
and that worked into your corporate schedule. So you were able to fit that in with
I had
travel.
My fixed appointment every Saturday and I ticked the box. And what I also learned, it gave me peace of mind because I didn't feel bad about my health and my fitness because I was like every Saturday at 10:30, I was like, okay, done with the workout. Perfect. So I brought my husband in. We brought a lot of friends and so we became fans of this product. And at the same time, we bought a vacation home here in Central Florida in celebration. We are Disney people. We love Disney. And I wanted to spend more time. And we found out about celebration. We bought a vacation home 6 years ago, a condo there. And the more time we spent here, the more we fell in love with Central Florida. Orlando, you know, that has not a really good reputation. People think it's just theme parks and a big convention center.
But is that what people elsewhere think? I think it's like Mickey Mouse and
theme parks.
Theme parks. Yeah.
Accurate.
And but probably, you know, the more you get to know Orlando, then we got to know the world beyond Disney. And we really fell in love. And we said we want to find a way to move here before we retire. Because a lot of people are planning to retire in Florida, right? If they retire, and I was like, I don't want to find friends if I'm 67. I want to find friends now and retire with my friends. So
that makes a lot of sense.
And a friend of us introduced us to the founder and owner of Body Street in Germany, and we learned that they want to go to the United States. And
so did this happen at like a cocktail party where you guys were just talking and it just happened to come up?
Kind of that, yeah. So we talked to our friend and say, hey, we think about moving to the US and we think buying a franchise is a good way to get a visa. And so there's a business visa attached to that. So that's a way to move here. And I was like, I have no idea what I want to do. I don't know where my passion is. And he said, so let's, here's some options. For example, we know the owners of Body Street, Matthias, Lena, and Emma Lena. And we are friends with them, so I can introduce you to them. And then they invited us to a barbecue. And I mean, now the rest is history. Wow. So they said, let's do
it. I love stories like that.
We just had to wait until the FDA
approved the machines, right?
Yes. Okay. And that took, I think, all 5 years. So we just had to wait 2 years. But as soon as they approved the machines, we were like, okay, let's.
So did Body Street already submit the machines for approval before your conversation happened?
Yes. Okay. Not Body Street. It's Miha Body Tech, the producer of these machines. Yeah, that all happened before. So they were kind of like in the works finding the first franchisees. And then we showed up and they were like, okay, let's do it with these guys.
They're like, these guys are solid.
Yeah. So that was the FDA here, approving them here. How long before were they already existing in Germany?
Yeah. And so Body Street is on the market now for 17 years.
Wow.
I think Miha Body Tech, they might be on the market also 18 years.
Wow. Okay.
Electrical muscle stimulation itself is in the rehab industry, in the medicine industry, they used it for centuries.
Well, no, that's what I was talking about. Emily Murphy's who I was telling you about. She used to be the co-host of the show, and she's really into fitness. And she said they use that to like rehabilitate her knee.
So
that's how it got started. Is then with rehabilitation, huh?
Yeah. So in the rehabilitation industry, this is pretty common. Like you might have heard about TENS units. So it's the same thing. So the science behind it, if muscles get an electrical impulse, they contract. That's how our body works. Our brain, when we move, our brain constantly sends electrical impulses to the muscles and let them contract. The muscle itself is dumb. So it's even on a dead body, if you put an electrical impulse, the muscle will contract.
That's cool.
So the muscle,
I know, right?
So the muscle cannot differentiate if your brain sends the impulse or if it comes from outside. So this is like a shortcut. So we let the muscles contract 85 times, which is faster than your brain would ever be able to contract the muscle, 85 times per second. But not just one muscle, 82 to 89% of the muscles in your body get contracted.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, that's what I thought was so great is I felt sore, but I felt sore evenly throughout my body. Because, mm-hmm. you know, when you go to the gym and you work out, it's like arm day or mm-hmm. leg day right. or your back and shoulders. And then the next day, you're like, just that one body part. Mm-hmm. I felt evenly sore, but it yeah. felt good. Mm-hmm. Like I could still move. Mm-hmm. All right. So that's the first part of the story. When we get back, we're going to talk. We're going to fill in the next few blocks for what happened with Body Street, because this is actually really interesting. So
it is.
Stay tuned for more Bad Radio.
You can do that, right? Perfect. Okay. Check out Bad Radio on the internet. Yeah. BAADD radio.com.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore, because a couple that plays together stays together.
Oh, yeah. Welcome back, and this portion of the show is brought to you by Frogger's Grill and Bar. Are you ready for the ultimate sports experience? Then look no further than Frogger's Grill and Bar. We've got your sports fix covered with Saturday and Sunday football. Catch all the action on tons of high-definition TVs while enjoying drink specials available all week long. And don't miss out on Frogger's amazing menu, where everything is fresh, never frozen. Oviedo, Mount Dora, Apopka, and Altamont Springs. Frogger's, hop in with food and fun. All right, so we are here with Stefan. Like, it's an American thing. You know that, right? With Body Street in Winter Park. And again, it is a 20-minute workout you do once a week that's equivalent to 3 hours mm-hmm. at the gym with a personal trainer.
Correct.
Using electromagnetic pulse.
Electrical muscle stimulation.
Okay. I'll say it again.
Close enough.
Muscle stimulation. And so before the break, we were talking about, you said it was 80 times per second.
85 times per second. Yeah.
That's all right. So Melissa and I got to go and do that. We went on a field trip.
Yeah.
To Body Street. And it was such a cool experience. Mm-hmm. And the funny thing was, is I had an idea of what it was about.
That's
Melissa
the thing.
Had no mm-hmm. idea. Mm-hmm. Like, I was just like,
I went in blind.
I was like, we're doing this. Come
and
join
I was
us.
Like, all right.
And so tell us how it all works. So we're going to talk about the location. We're going to mm-hmm. talk about what we put on. We're going to talk about how you get it wet and why you do all the things that you do.
So we do a virtual studio tour now.
Yes.
Okay, great. So what we do, because we are new, and we are in the same situation that Body Street was 16 years ago. Nobody knew what's going on, mm-hmm. right? And as soon as you say 20 minutes once a week, everybody's like, nah, I don't. That's
we talked about that. It's like we have, like, especially people like Gen Xers, like mm-hmm. me, or even older. Mm-hmm. It's like, if it's not 3 to 5 times at the gym, mm-hmm. if it's not your heart rate for 20 minutes, if it's not 1,200 calories a day,
at least an hour,
at least, you know, then mm-hmm. it's not going to work.
So that's why we still do free trials. So we want people to come in and to try it. And even if you say, oh, I have my gym routine, I'm happy with it, great, keep it as long as you can and as long as you're happy with your results. We don't want to see you. We are here for all people that don't have mm-hmm. hours and hours and hours mm-hmm. spent at the gym mm-hmm. or people just don't like going to the gym. Mm-hmm. So again, we do free trials because if you tried it, then you understand how mighty it is. You mm-hmm. just explained how you felt after the workout. You felt like you had a really whole body workout. Mm-hmm. So that's why we still do free trials. And you just call the studio or go on our website and put in your information in. Then we reach out to you. We work appointment based. So
okay, appointments.
There's always a personal trainer in front of you, and we have two machines at the location. So mm-hmm. never more than two people at the same time. And we always say around about 30 minutes before the workout, we do a studio tour, we do a consultation. There are some indications where we cannot work with you. If you, for example, if you have a pacemaker, you're pregnant, or if you're sick, you shouldn't work out anyway. Mm-hmm. So.
Right.
But pacemaker pregnancy is a no-no. We don't want to work with you. Mm-hmm. And there's a little waiver to sign. And then we have a quick consultation. We want to know where your fitness level is and what your goals are. And then we do the workout. Mm-hmm. So, and for the workout, there's nothing that you need to bring. This is another weird thing for a lot of people, going to the gym without having a gym bag
right.
with
mm-hmm.
you.
Or tennis shoes. I even brought, mm-hmm. I came in flip-flops, but I brought my workout shoes and I didn't mm-hmm. use them.
Yeah,
because you gave me socks.
We provide you with everything that you need for the workout. We provide you with a bodysuit. It's like an underwear. It's a special fabric. It comes from the manufacturers of these machines. It just helps to provide the impulse.
Mm-hmm.
And we work also, we also just use grip socks for the workout, mm-hmm. because we also, our sneakers, they let us unlearn how to use our grip and our feet. And mm-hmm. we kind of like relearn that during the workout, mm-hmm. because the impulse mm-hmm. also works down there in your feet and in your calves.
Well, you know what we can do too? Because I have the pictures that you took. Mm-hmm. So when she's putting the video together, when you say that, we're going to show the pictures of mm-hmm. like you had like strapped me in.
Yeah. Yeah. And so you have that suit on, and then we have a vest for you, and we have straps for the arms, for the legs, and a belt for the glutes. Mm-hmm. And with that, we recruit 92 to 98% of all of the muscles in the body. So even if the strap is just on your biceps, it also you also felt it probably mm-hmm. tingling in your fingers. So you also recruit mm-hmm. all the muscles on your underarm.
So tell me, why did you have to get it wet? You got it damp.
Yeah, we want the impulse really conducted. And water is just a good conductor. That's why we spray the electrodes with warm water. That's the only reason.
And she's like, it didn't feel warm to me. She was over there freezing her toe.
I get cold really easily. And I saw the water happening. I was like, it's going to be warm at first, but I know what happens.
Yeah, yeah. And the temperature at the studio is at 71 mm-hmm. degrees, which is, it's a workout, right? Mm-hmm. You saw that. You warm up pretty quickly. Mm-hmm. So that's why the temperature in the studio is not just for people talking. The temperature in the studio is for people working out. So mm-hmm. that's why if you're just sitting there for 30 minutes and doing a studio tour, it might get cold. So.
Like it does in this studio right here. Mm-hmm.
And then we put you in the suit, and then a trainer for the first session, we get you familiar with the impulse first, because as you both saw, everybody reacts differently. Some people are like really like, oh my God, this feels so good. This feels like a massage. Some people are like, oh, this is too high.
We acted like a couple of wimps.
We were such big wusses.
And that's why you saw there's always somebody in front of you who uh-huh. kind of like, and we get you adjusted, and we also put your profile. So we control.
It's like a little card that you put in
the different levels for mm-hmm. the different muscle groups. It's like going to the gym, right? You need to learn or to memorize which weights are mm-hmm. used for which body part. Here we save that all on an electronic card. So if we set up your profile, we save that there. If you come in next week, we put the card on the machine. We start right away
I
where
think
you
that's
ended.
Awesome.
So
I know. So we got on there, and then the different, we kind of did a little test, mm-hmm. and then I was like, oh, that's too much, or that one I can take a little bit more there.
Yeah, and everybody is different, so everybody has a different profile, and we want to find we always say challenging but doable. Mm-hmm. So you felt it. It starts with a little tickling experience, and then if we dial it up, it's getting stronger until mm-hmm. a point where it's getting uncomfortable, like mm-hmm. a cramp, like a controlled mm-hmm. cramp.
Yeah.
We don't want to have the pain, but it also shouldn't be too easy. It's like mm-hmm. going to the gym. If you lift weights, you don't want to have mm-hmm. them too light. You don't want to have them too heavy. We try to find that sweet spot where it's challenging mm-hmm. but doable, and then you have the best outcome for this with mm-hmm. this workout. And then the trainer guides you just through 20 minutes. It's like isometric poses.
So I was curious so the poses help you focus on different body parts?
Yes.
Is that mm-hmm. how that works?
Yeah. So the key to this workout mm-hmm. is that you contract mm-hmm. different muscles. Mm-hmm. So the impulse is the one thing, the 85 contractions per second. This is for your whole mm-hmm. body through the whole workout. But also you want to kind of like focus on different muscle groups like biceps.
But it's still like when I'm going to say vibrating in mm-hmm. a minute. Mm-hmm. So like when you do the countdown, so it's like it turns green and you can kind of like, mm-hmm. and then it yeah. kind of counts down. Then you see it turning yellow, and that's when you know you need to get into mm-hmm. your position.
Yes.
And mm-hmm. like you're flexing your belly, but you still feel it's still mm-hmm. everything's still vibrating, right. But you're mm-hmm. focusing on
mm-hmm. different muscle groups. And then you really get the full flex like you would lift weights with mm-hmm. that mm-hmm. muscle. But again, the slow twitch muscles or the fast twitch muscles still work on the rest of mm-hmm. your body. So
if
that's,
you just put mm-hmm. it on and didn't do a series of
mm-hmm. like
things, would yeah. you still feel it the next
no.
day?
So no.
Okay.
Maybe you would just cramp. It would mm-hmm. look really funny.
That's what it was. You're like, she said that too. She was like, you'll be like,
yeah.
But it wouldn't be. You wouldn't have that effect. So uh-huh. the effect, really, the key to this workout is really the trainer who guides you and mm-hmm. who makes sure that you really focus on the different muscle groups and that you contract the different muscle groups. And with the poses, with the workout that we guide you through, we work our way through the whole body. There's a reason why we started with different mm-hmm. and end with other positions. So
well, everything's like goes back to the squat position, mm-hmm. right?
Yes.
That's what it was.
That's
like
our default. And we also, with some members, we kind of like skip the basic squat mm-hmm. because they already know what to do, how mm-hmm. to do. That's also over the weeks, over the months, you get better. So it's, we mix the poses up every month.
Oh, okay. The midsection. I was gonna wonder that, because it's like, I wonder if it starts to get a little boring if you're doing the same thing, but it is 20 minutes. So
if you want to build muscle or maintain muscle, there's two things that you need to do. One is you need to do the same again and again and again. Repetition, right? But the other thing is you also need to mix it up, because mm-hmm. otherwise you plateau. So that's why we mix the midsection.
Is that called muscle memory or something like that? Where you just kind of
it's like motion plateau. Memory. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's very interesting. So he's like, stop talking now, because he heard music. He's like, that means
I know how this works.
He knows
now.
How it goes. Yeah, he's a pro.
All right, well, we are going to go to break, and when we get back, we're going to have more Bad Radio, so stay tuned.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore, because a couple that plays together stays together.
Welcome back, and this portion of the show is brought to you by Liberty Property Inspections. Your home is one of your most important investments, so don't trust it to just anyone. LibertyPropertyInspections.net, helping you protect your investment. All right, so we're here with Body Street in Winter Park, and we're having a great conversation. Mm-hmm. And there's so much to talk about, mm-hmm. and it's almost like I want to make sure we don't forget any part of it. So we talked a little bit about the history of Body Street, and then we talked a little bit about the technology. So I want to talk a little bit more about getting this location open, mm-hmm. and then what are some of your goals for moving forward? One of them, obviously, is to get the word out, because by listening to that last segment, you can kind of figure it's not the easiest thing in the world to explain to people. Mm-hmm.
That's correct. Yeah.
So what were some of the things that you, because you tried to open up right during COVID, didn't mm-hmm. you?
I mean, it wasn't the plan. I mean, who planned?
No. Right.
So yeah, it was a rough time. So we found the location. So again, FDA approved, machines got approved by the FDA. We were like, okay, let's quit our big corporate jobs. Then we were looking
for
a location.
So brave.
And found the location in Winter Park, did the build out, and we were ready to open in March 2020. So we all know March 2020, COVID hit, short lockdowns in Florida, but then we also had to leave the country because we were here on a tourist visa, mm-hmm. and the consulate shut down, and they didn't continue to work on our business visa. So that's why we had to leave the country again. Had a summer, beautiful summer in Munich, but it's not beautiful if you know that you have a business and mm-hmm. on the other side of the ocean. And, mm-hmm. and then there was the travel ban, so we were not able to come back. Mm. And
How long was that? 3 months?
No, it was longer. So we were able to come back in November 2020. So it was.
And so did the building just
months.
Sit there,
yes,
or did you have
yes.
somebody come and look
at
it?
No, it was just sat there, and we paid the lease. And so anyway,
bless your heart.
But finally, we were able to open in November 2020, and that was still the time where there was no vaccines on the horizon. Everybody was like scared to walk out, and. We did a lot of networking before that. So mm-hmm. we were able to kind of open the studio and invite the first guest, like, hey, let us try and let's start mm-hmm. getting the word out. And people loved it, because that was the time where a lot of people did not go to the regular gym because mm-hmm. they felt scared.
Well, yeah, because if you think about it, I mean, maybe you just do one at a time if mm-hmm. people are really nervous.
Also, I mean, even the two, like I can see like having two with like masks.
Yeah, we started with 50% capacity. Mm-hmm. So there was just one person in the studio, our trainers, we wore masks. Mm-hmm. So people felt safe.
Right.
And also then people who went to the gym before, some people started crying after the workout because they said, oh my God, I miss this feeling so much. So people really felt like how much they missed the workout and how important that is also for mental health.
So it was such an emotional time regardless, because nobody really understood what was happening. So that was a big piece of it right there.
And also a lot of people think about muscle. It's about looking good and looking sexy. And people say, I don't need to look sexy anymore. I'm married, da-di-da. It's not muscle.
I don't believe that at all.
Muscle is so important for mental health, for hormones, for bone density, so many things. And people don't know that. Not a lot of people know that. So that's why resistance training is important. So, so then we opened step by step. And so now it's our third year, and we are still rocking and rolling. And now we see the potential. Now we see how much people love it. We see, and that's something that I didn't know, because I did not work in the fitness industry before, but I see now how rewarding it is to see how you change people's life, how you touch people's life, how you help people to get healthier and happier with just one workout. So And yeah, now we are about to sign the area developer agreement for mm-hmm. Florida. So mm-hmm. I will be the person who's helping finding the next franchisees.
Oh, nice.
And opening the next locations, which we already did. So the mm-hmm. second location opened 2 months ago mm-hmm. in Jupiter. And the third location is opening, fingers crossed, in 4 weeks in Winter Garden.
Oh,
and
wow.
we are already awesome. In conversations with 3 more franchise partners here nice. In the Orlando area. So
oh,
we really want to.
Congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
Wow.
That is so great. I was thinking about the benefits of it as well for people that have been in auto accidents or they mm-hmm. have like a bad back. I mean, is this like an alternative to having to actually go to the gym if you've got that sort of thing mm-hmm. happening, right?
A lot of people have restrictions, like elderly people, they cannot mm-hmm. lift weights anymore because the joints just don't support that anymore.
Right.
So our oldest client is 84.
That's awesome.
And she said, I cannot lift weights anymore because my joints are so... But she's still maintaining her muscle with our mm-hmm. workout because it's zero impact on the joints. We also
right.
have a blind veteran. We work together with the VA.
Oh, wow. I didn't think about that, too.
Yes. Blind people cannot hit the gym and just start lifting weights. So they need mm-hmm. help, a personal trainer. But we all know personal trainers are pricey, right? Mm-hmm.
Right.
And we worked together with the VA and they checked our workout
really?
And they said this is the most inclusive workout that they ever saw. So so for people with disabilities, people who yeah
mm-hmm,
with
right.
with any kind of disabilities. Mm-hmm. So it's a very, I would say, inclusive workout. Everyone can do it. I know in Germany there's people who come in wheelchairs.
I was about to ask that. Mm-hmm. I was curious because they can still do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because even. Man, think about that, because lots
right.
of times people's legs like deteriorate
mm-hmm.
because they're in, so that this can actually help them keep their muscles.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that until
mm-hmm.
just right now.
Yeah.
Even for things that are less minor, like if you have like a knee injury or something like that, then a lot of times the whole rest of your body kind of just goes because you're like, oh, I can't go to the gym
yeah.
because I
yeah.
can't do X, Y, Z. But with this, you can kind of bypass all that
yeah.
and just focus on everything. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, you did mention the cost of a personal trainer, and I mm-hmm. asked if it was okay if we talked about the cost before we are on the air. And so what does it cost to
yeah.
be a member?
Yeah, so we work membership-based because we don't believe that the single workout changes anything.
Mm-hmm.
You tried it, you feel great after that, mm-hmm. but there will be no change because just this one workout, right?
Mm-hmm.
We want you to come. We just want to see you once a week.
Mm-hmm.
And I will say everybody can do once a week, 20 minutes. So, mm-hmm. We work membership based and the memberships start at $49.90 a week.
Mm-hmm.
So, but again, that gives you a workout worth 3 hours with a personal trainer. So,
and that's really what you need to think about
mm-hmm.
is what the cost would be. Not, I mean, I wouldn't equate it to the cost of going to Crunch or to a local gym because that's just not what you're getting.
Mm-hmm.
It would be going to a local gym and then having a personal trainer
right.
with you for 3 hours.
And saving you the time.
And the time.
Because
so if you
minutes.
Think about
yeah.
it, it's a deal.
It's,
right.
it's $200 a month
uh-huh.
if you do that. And I think that's right the alley where all
mm-hmm.
the other Orange Theories, CrossFits
mm-hmm.
also are. So
mm-hmm.
And
right.
that's what I like about this. This technology there's already a market for that. And we have a lot of trainers who travel from client to client with these machines. There's a
oh,
market
really?
For that as well, but they charge a ton of money.
I'm
for
sure.
That. So
yeah.
like a lot of celebrities in Hollywood get trained by these machines. So and what I like about Body Street, we make this technology accessible for,
mm-hmm.
for almost everybody. And we just try to help people
mm-hmm.
with their health.
I have a question about calories. So this really
mm-hmm.
is not a calorie burning muscle building.
So the focus is the muscle building, the muscle toning. During this workout and after that, you burn around 500 to 800 calories.
Which is still good, yeah.
But it's not the main goal. So
right.
one workout a week would not be enough. So with the American diet, once a week burning 500 calories is not
right.
enough. So you need to do something else
mm-hmm.
if you want to burn fat. So
right.
But if you want to have your whole body workout traditionally, you need to spend 3 hours at the regular gym. You don't burn a lot of calorie with just lifting weights. With
no.
You. So that's why you need to add on your cardio on that.
Mm-hmm.
So if you think about how much time you save, and if you then say, okay, now I can, the time that it saves me,
mm-hmm.
I still want to work out. If you can do then running, yoga,
mm-hmm.
any light stuff, swimming, cycling, high intensity interval training.
That's
so then,
perfect. Mm-hmm. I think about, I like to go to the gym, but I like to do cardio.
Mm-hmm.
But I put my headphones on and I
mm-hmm.
just sort of zone out,
mm-hmm.
and that's kind of like
my therapy, I right. guess you could say. Yep. But then when I'm done doing that, I very rarely like could get into the body workout. Mm-hmm. So that is like perfect. So I could incorporate that's going to be one of my questions is incorporate more of another type of exercise like cardio.
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
Yes, yes. So this would be your one-stop shop for strength building. So you don't need to lift any weights or mm-hmm. and do any resistance training beside mm-hmm. this. If you want, you could on the other half of the week. So you want to have because this hits all your muscles in your body all at once, you want to have 2 to 3 days to recover after that. Mm-hmm. But after that, on the other half of the week, you can start lifting again if you want.
If you want to. All right, well, that 10 minutes flew by so fast. So stay tuned when we get back. We're going to have more Bad Radio.
We'll wrap things up next. You stay right there. It's News Radio WFLA Orlando.
Welcome back to Bad Radio, brought to you by Premier Couple Superstore. Because a couple that plays together stays together.
I'd like to give a huge thank you to our sponsor, Bolts Legal. Fear no storm with BoltsLegal.com. Thank you to 33 Tanning Spa with locations in Altamont Springs and Longwood. I chatted with Erin yesterday via text. I love her. We need to have her back in. Uh-huh. Yeah. Andrews Law PA, auto accident attorney. Contact Andrews Law today at andrewslawpa.com. And Crazy Muscle Nutrition with their new address of 1015 Unit 129 State Road 436 in Castleberry. And then this is the one that I was telling you about, is Imbalance Body Work. Mm-hmm. Is 407-801-8503 or info at imbalance.com. And what Derek Brantley is he's somebody that works with deep muscle tissue or mm-hmm. I don't know if it's deep tissue muscle or deep muscle tissue, but he gets in there and he helps people work out like their aches and their pains, but more on like a therapy type of thing. Mm-hmm. So he's not a masseuse and he's not an acupuncture therapist. It's kind of like in between, and it's technology that came from Canada. Mm-hmm. So when I say technology, it's not really, it's the skill set from Canada. So I think that you guys would be great referral partners too. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're talking with Body Street, and during the break we brought up our experience, and I think Melissa had a very valid point. So when we went and did our free trial, I had a good idea of what it was all about. Mm-hmm. Melissa did not. So her and I kind of had two different experiences. Because you get all suited up, and then I'm not going to say, do people say zapped, or I mean, what do you guys I mean initially zapped. Zapped. It's zapped. Like, so what it does is it you constrict, so everything it tightens up, it vibrates. Mm-hmm. And at first it's such a unique sensation that you're not really sure what to make of it. And I think for both of us, like I said, she said we were wusses, so I think that we both were kind of like, whoa, what was that? So what are some of the reactions that you have from people? You said some people are like, oh, it's the best thing ever.
Yes, that's what's most people, they are like, in the beginning, they are really nervous because you really don't know what to expect. Mm-hmm. And then you feel like that, and a lot of people say it's like a tickling experience. Yeah. Somebody said it's like, oh, it feels like 1,000 iPhones vibrating on my body. And then we get more intense and try to find that level where it's again challenging but doable, and most people really love it. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have some, and again, I think with you, Melissa, normally if people come in, we ask, hey, how did you hear about us? Mm-hmm. And so we make a little kind of like make sure that you know what to expect. We also make sure that people are well hydrated, that they had a little snack or something before, because it's a workout.
Well, right? That's was something I got a text earlier, and it says, make sure that you have, and I didn't share that with you either. I'm really sorry.
No,
I
did.
Did I tell you? Yeah. And I be did hydrated and have a snack.
Yeah, I did those.
Yeah, yeah. And then people love it. And that's why I love free trials. That's my favorite part because I love to see the faces of the people. And then also after 5 minutes, everyone was like, oh, this is a workout.
Right.
When she said
you're at the 10-minute mark, I was like, that's it? I was like, we're only halfway through.
Honestly, I thought it was going by fast, honestly.
Really?
I was like, wow, 10 minutes already. I guess I was just so focused on like...
When she said 10 minutes, I thought we were like, closer to being done, but that second 10 minutes went a lot faster. Mm-hmm. So when she finally said, you know, we're done, I was like, oh, okay, that happened fast. So your point was is that you felt like what we're doing right now is getting people prepared,
right?
And so they understand that you're going to feel a whole body sensation that you probably have not felt before.
Yeah, so for more people to come in and like have that, like, love it immediately if they're new, If you've ever felt like a TENS unit, that's exactly what it is.
Are you saying, what are you saying?
TENS unit. It's like, my dad was a physical therapist, so he would use that for rehabilitation.
Yeah. Why don't you say, it's like a sonogram when you do it for rehabilitation. I had it in my shoulder, and it kind of tweaks and then sends an electric shock. Is that pretty much what we're talking about?
Does the sonogram do the same thing?
Oh, yeah, cool.
Yeah, so if you've had any of that type of physical therapy.
It's that sensation.
It's that sensation. We're a little bit of a muscle grab, and then a
Right.
And it's repeated.
And imagine that on your whole body.
On your
whole
body.
I would love to. I'll try.
he's offering free trials. We'll have to bring our video, though, because I would love to video her doing it.
So I would just suggest, like, people check out the website, check out what it's about, and kind of have that kind of sensation in mind if you have had experience with that. Just having that kind of, you're already prepared for that, will help you when you're actually doing the movements, because doing the movements, you need to kind of contract all your muscles so that when those pulses do come through, you're not just like, you know, how you're saying.
Yeah, you just like tense up. If you're
tensing up, it makes it a lot more bearable, like that, the sensation.
But I also remember after the first 10 minutes, Melissa, you felt much better. You felt much more confident.
I knew what was
happening. Yes. Yeah.
Or what to expect.
I know the first workout is something new. You have the new everything is new, right? It's like going to the gym the first time. It can be overwhelming. It's the same thing here.
And so the different motions, so the ones that I noticed that I like the most is like when we did the side to side motions. So everybody has their own different, I guess you could say, the things that work better for them. Is that based off of our muscle composition now, or like what kind of shape we're in now, which one feels the best or is the easiest for us?
I would say it's different. So I would always say the sore, where you felt the sore the most, this is probably the weakest part. So a lot of people felt the triceps a lot. Because if we do...
I felt my thighs. What are these? Thighs.
That's because of the squats. There's a lot of squats that we do. Yeah, but again, I did now hundreds of test trials and we're... Everybody's different. Really, everybody reacts different. There are people that love running, people that hate running. There are people that love lifting. And it's... Yeah.
What kind of like differentiation do you see between men and women?
So that's a really good question. So women have in general a higher pain tolerance.
That to us and we're like, not us.
Yeah, not you. So... No, and sometimes we have couples. So we also have couples who come together with their kids. And so women have the higher pain tolerance and men are the competitive part. So, and it's all, sometimes it's like, what level is she at? And she's always higher because...
Really?
Yeah, so it's fun, yeah. But also, the more in shape you are, the more intense the impulse is. Because fat is not a really good
conductor.
That's
what we're talking about with my husband, Tom.
And we have some members who are with us now for 2.5 years, and they lost, so one lost 40 pounds of fat, and his levels went down over time because there's the less fat is between the impulse and the muscle, intense the impulse gets the muscle. So that's...
Well, we talked about that because I was like, I don't think my husband, Tom, would like this at all. But he's got like really low, and I want to talk about that. Yeah, body fat. I want to talk about that too because that was interesting. We talked about what was it, not BMI, and tell me what you were saying about that, because we were talking about that just as like your weight and your height, right?
So we do with our members, we do every 3 months, we do a body scan, an in-body body scan.
And you have that machine there.
Yeah, we have the machine there. So we want to show what's going on in their body, because for a lot of people, it's confusing. And for some people, they gain a little bit of weight when they start our workout, which is good weight because they gain muscle. But that's not what they expect if they go to the gym, right? And we want to show, okay, this is, you kept the same weight, but you gained 5 pounds of muscle and you lost 5 pounds of fat. So that's why you're toning up, because muscle has 7 times less volume than fat.
Right.
So, we do that. And you mentioned BMI, and BMI, I don't understand why it's still an industry standard, because it just looks at your height and your weight, but not what you are made of.
Doesn't make sense.
So I feel pretty athletic. If I look at my BMI, I'm in the obese section.
That's so crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy. And every muscular person that you see that you put on the BMI scale is in the obese section. Mm-hmm. That's why it doesn't make sense. We look at percentage of body fat. We want to bring the percentage of body fat to a healthy level, which depends on the age where you're at and the gender. that you are.
Yeah, I think that's an American thing, too. It's all about the scale. So that music means that we are wrapping the show up. Now, I want you to give all your contact information and help people to get their free trial.
Yes. So Google Body Street. Our website is bodystreet.us/winter-park. Our phone number is 407-346-5311. You can call, you can send an inquiry through a website, and I would love to see you all.
Awesome. And you can find me at melissa@strikingbrand.com, and strikingbrand.com is a website.
And I'm Angela at Bad Radio on Facebook. It's Business at a Distance, Central Florida Networking. Huge thank you to our sponsors, and thank you for tuning in. Have a great week, everyone.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to say thank you to Winter Park City Lifestyle for watching our video. And they said, isn't Body Street Winter Park so awesome?
Yes, it is.
This is Bad Radio. See you next Sunday at 11.